this is Dr. Justine Agnieszka Chevalier. Now I will go through drugs of so-called abuse one by one and divide them into groups, and then I will make you realize that mind content and physiological, physical changes in relation to presence of the opposite gender partner, sexual one, mimic and are necessary descriptions of those drugs and are necessary for those drugs to take action. And if mind content and physical state in non-pursuit or fallout of that relationship is not the case, those drugs do not perform their functions and cause so-called paradoxical effects. Placebo effect is not 30% in many cases, it is much higher, and most of those changes are excluded from medical arts and psychology. Descriptions of sexual surrender, which is a state of preparation to be pursued in sexual act to have a child, wanted one, and sexual arousal, which is a state of approximation for two people in space to have wanted sex always, and sexual arousal is also to have the active part usually played by the male and acted by a pursuit of the female in sexual surrender, as opposed to having sexual surrender happen to a man, which is normal when that female has capacity to prove reciprocity by saving that man and distribute co-eating, co-pursuit for other activities into couple unit. Mistake to the person, like I already mentioned, causes diseases. If we accuse the wrong person, force a wrong person, or try to propose self or another, or accused of that, that is the difference between pleasure versus distress, fight or flight or distress, and disgust as well, nothing else. And those drugs, they do not take that aspect or that division away. Aversion versus pursuit based on pleasure, meaning it in two, in same pleasurable reciprocity, labeling as being under influence of drugs and caused by drugs, as opposed to enchanted by sexual arousal in function of self of the other person, causes that we don't have relationships and families, but people buying and spending money on drugs. And that is why the purpose of those videos is to educate and explain that question, answer again, what is the source of hyperesthesia, wanted, pleasurable one, because there's one that is painful, like in autism, caused by Molly, for instance. The cause of it is a woman, because that was referred to me by a man, that causes us an individual in looks and in reciprocity by own sexual arousal and pursuit to seduce that woman to have family with that man, sorry, to have family with, causes that man is hypersensitivity to her touch, meaning she does not have to do much and he feels lots of pleasure. So what's the source? It is that individual as opposed to all others, remembered as such and also in person. Sexual partner. Molly, without that individual, if she was absent, taken by that man, or if she was not at all sexual partner ever, does not cause such, because that substance does not provide memories or substrate to enhancing what is missing in real life as pursuit of a relationship. So let's start. Alcohol. Alcohol is classified as sedative. Sedation after alcohol happens in stages. First stage of alcohol, which is all attributed to substance, is joy and euphoria. Then after ingestion, talkativeness, etc., socializing, and then it is a progressive stupor towards sleepiness. All of those mimic, because alcohol is a social drink also used in weddings, meeting with a person who is not declared yet as sexual partner, and progression to silence and sexual surrender, in which a realization of desire happens. The uncomfortable silences that are in pleasure to discover that one is desired. And then stupor to actually fall in arms of the one another and have sex. And that is alcohol or not, caused by presence in function of the one another of person of opposite gender. And that is not action of alcohol, that happens with or without alcohol, and it is disgusted upon when the person assumes that that person is source in absence of such changes in self, it takes two, and when person observes it and assumes that this is the substance, which is also false. If there's no relationship, that alcohol and those phases fall apart and follow different unpredictable rules medically. Remember, those are mind drugs, which means common social patterns and phenomena such as love have to happen and be present, or those drugs, they do nothing, as if you were drinking water, or as if something that is very strong that you've taken took effect. Next, all hallucinogenics such as cactuses, LSD, and I think also PCP, and all of those that cause hallucination are things that merge happenings in pleasure of the around person of others that are in real time happening to match situational, for instance, present in I don't know, some remote space in some household, for instance, match persons or participants with same degree of pleasure, and it is also in context of sexuality, assuming that, for instance, a person who is present in a room is the person who is in fact loved but absent the same, and drug is then blamed to perform sexual activity as source is the person who is loved as opposed to one that is present in physically, and that is suppressed as creating confusion to identity to perform that asexual act in disregard of need for physical body and mind together to have that pressure normally if there is nothing to blame on happen. And that is why then there is hangover or that drug remorse. That whole thing is because of separation from mind and body and discarding of mind as unrelated to the body or unnecessary. So that's what I'm saying. Pleasure or those hallucinations that persons or things change, or that in mind one has strong sexual experiences or ecstasy, happen as well without the drugs when persons are separated as couples, for instance, traveling, and happen and can be confirmed. And that is a temporary period of time pending reciprocity and pursuit of such relationship to give promise and give motivation to pursue such relationship in real life. When blamed in drugs, person one or the other, depending who is using, disgusts upon the other as not loving but using drugs, and sexual arousal and pleasure is blamed as source on the substance as opposed to that person, and the relationships fall apart or are not pursued. And that is why that is ignorance and it needs to change. Next, so-called, here we have central nervous system depressants. All of those that include also alcohol, this is a bad division, include also heroin, include as well all of the major and minor antipsychotics. And let me see what else is in here so that we don't spend too much time on it. That's actually on opioids, opioids and painkillers. All of those cause state that is stupor for two reasons. Have sex with partner who is inappropriate or endure such love and intimacy or unwanted company, being in company less wanted than at least one. That is how. And that's the reason, including pleasure lived in reciprocity to a sufficient degree that another person observing, for instance, mouth, teeth, or body, or pursuing, causes pain, sheer physical discomfort, sheer pain. Source of pain is having possibility to pursue that relationship, not doing so, and pain occurs then in the need of sedation as well as fall apart of body because somebody else who is unwanted is in need to fight back to be present, for instance, in the area that the couple wants to have sex or children, or that person needs to fight back and is stressed because of that person, that person who is preferred lived to a sufficient degree to become exclusive in mind as source of pleasure, and others present or pursuing create rejection and need to be mindful or push back. So those are that's the role of sedatives. Are they needed? Sure, if it is instead of, for instance, natural regeneration, and instead of also the pursuit of the relationship, those all of those function and can be short term to fix or to alleviate, administered. However, their fix or cure depends on that education and knowledge of how to pursue. And also, in of course, flexibility, because that involves others, of putting into practice those things and having others collaborate. The next drugs, so those are the sedatives. The next reason to have and source of that sedation is having an impression that blaming on that sedation discards, when it comes to stress and other things, discards the risk of being accused of being passive or indifferent, because that can be blamed on a drug. Passiveness or indifference is strength in knowing that there is another option or another person waiting, as opposed to having that place or person taken as most important or omitted, avoided. So that is the sedation. The second, mimicking, or in other words, occurring concomitantly state, blamed or drugged, as opposed to that phenomenon, is sexual surrender, which I spoke in prior videos about, meaning slurred speech, falling, going down as if under anesthesia. All those that are blamed on drugs are caused when, if we remember as adults, when we are with a lover and that love is wanted and that person is about to approach or whisper or kiss. That is the that state of drowsiness that alcohol causes, and is in function of dissociating from identity and doing so to blame it on that alcohol as opposed to another person, in presence of persons that could be consciously acknowledged and known about. Does that happen often? If person is in new place or conscious, that does not happen. So alcohol then is drunk as water, or as they drink, social drink, the same when is there's need for work, because lives depend on it. And so that is about sedatives I covered, and stimulants. And then I will talk about hallucinogenics also I covered. Tobacco is a stimulant, tobacco is for social craving. Social craving, oral one, is to share food. So for instance, share common taste for water, enjoyment of that. To try substance for being drinkable, for instance, or eatable. And also to have urge, or that craving, oral one, that is for conversation and for kissing, for sexual pleasure, translated into something that is more socially acceptable. And that occurs in the function of two. So again, the question is who you are in love with that makes you search for kiss of that person, and is that person a smoker? So that is the culprit. Being independent causes cessation of those urges in all drugs and in all substances. Being independent, being in happy relationship, which is freedom and independence, or being alone in realization that none of the persons, all of them have a maximum limit set up, or there are more than one that do not have limit and does not pursue, or does not want to be pursued. So that's how.